Welcome back to Switch to Linux. Today we are going to continue looking at our series on distro versus distro. And this request came not actually from Feren OS, but it did come from somebody who asked me to compare Kubuntu and Feren OS next. Now, this series we're basically looking at multiple different, like two distros side by side that have some degree of commonality inside of them. So Feren OS originally was based on Linux Mint and ran the Cinnamon desktop. Now he is backed up to the Ubuntu base running Plasma. And Kubuntu, of course, is the official Ubuntu spin of Plasma. So we're going to have a look at these guys just kind of right out of the box. How do they work? How do they look? How do they idle? Basic things like that. And we're going to go ahead and start with Kubuntu. So here we are, and I did not install anything else. All I did is I installed the system and shut it down. So we do have a notice down here. I see that there are updates available. So we are getting an update notice down here. This runs through Discover. Now, this is one of the issues with Plasma is that Discover does tend to be a very buggy software store. It's one that I could never quite get working quite right on Fedora Plasma when I tried to use that. And in this case here, it appears as though it seems to be working. I like the general look of the thing, but ultimately, it does oftentimes feel a little bit buggy. If I remember correctly, I think Feren OS uses a different software manager, but we will check for sure when we get there. Also, before we get too far into this, I want to see what we have as far as our system resources. That way we can kind of get a general idea for how they idle. So we can see here we are running on 0.51 gigabytes of RAM, so a very respectable amount of RAM. We are in a virtual machine here, and both of these are identical virtual machines, 256 megabytes of video memory, and we have 6 gigs of RAM in each one. So as far as general functions inside of Kubuntu, we pretty much just have Ubuntu with Plasma installed. Not a lot of serious things that really stand out to me as far as real changes. Now, the installer, Kubuntu uses the Ubiquiti installer, which is an easier installer to use than Calamaris, and that Calamaris occasionally will crash on trying to get your disks partitioned. I did not encounter that issue with Feren OS. We'll talk a little bit more about that, though, a little bit later. As far as applications, we do have a minimal install and a normal install. I went with the normal install because that would bring me closer to a comparison with Feren OS, being as that Feren OS does not have a minimal install that I know of. So let's go ahead and have a look at some software versions and things like this. And ultimately, since Kubuntu, we're looking at Kubuntu 19.10 versus Feren OS is based on the 18.04 LTS base. You have to decide for yourself which one's better in this case. Here we have Plasma version 5.16, and we're running on the kernel 5.3, Qt version 5.12, and I'm not going to remember these numbers, so take note of them yourself. You can see everything else we have here. All right, so let's go ahead and have a look at LibreOffice. We are running 6.3.3.2. I suspect this is probably going to be newer than we're going to get in Feren OS, but we'll know for sure when we get over there. Of course, this version here, anything after 6.2, does allow you to have the ribbon appearance. So the default does not give us a ribbon appearance. But if you head on over down here to your user interface, you can see we have a variety of things. And if you pick tabbed, this is basically the Windows Office tab type approach. So you can see that. Not my favorite way of running it, but in this modern day, many people do want to see something like that. Let's go ahead while we're here and see if the spieling checker works. And it does appear it is. The spieling checker is going to work. Hey, spelling, peeling, spieling, 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 stealing, spelling. There you go. Let's go ahead and correct it. All right. And we do have our synonyms installed, which is nice and handy. Something we actually don't get in Linux Mint last I knew. So that's awesome that you pretty much have a lot of those basic tools out of the way. We do actually have our, looks like we do have desktop icons enabled by default on the desktop, but there's actually nothing there. Let's go ahead and configure the desktop, see what we have as far as appearances and things like this. So of course, here is your desktop view, which will prevent you from running icons, I believe. And folder view will allow you to put desktop icons on. So if you're running Plasma, that is kind of your difference. And if you're running it and you're like, I can't put icons on my desktop, that's the reason why. You need to go ahead and do that. Over here, I cannot remember exactly where the button is to actually add your desktop icons on here. It's in the settings somewhere, so it's going to be something that's going to be easy to find if we search for it. I just can't remember right off the top of my head. So, and since we're not reviewing Plasma, we're not going to bother looking for that necessarily. But there's out of our box. Our basic theming, let's go into our overall settings. System settings. So of course, inside of our system settings, we do have just your basic generic themes. We have the Kubuntu theme, which is the one we're running right here. It is nice. It's modern, has a little bit of translucency. We do have Breeze light, Breeze dark. Basic WordPress, basic workspace themes. We have just the ones we would expect. We have the Kubuntu is the only real custom one. We have the Oxygen, the Breeze, the Air, all the things that we find on top of this. here's desktop behavior, applications, display and monitor. I was just kind of seeing if I could search for the desktop icons real quick. They're there somewhere. I just can't remember exactly where they are. So there is your basic view. We have our icons are kind of set up. Our menus are set up with nice icons. Everything looks nice. We do have a very traditional layout. Not a lot of options to change it. We are using the application. I believe this is the application launcher is the name of this one. And we have, let's see, show alternatives. We have application dashboard, application launcher, application menu. And we do have a simple menu as our options for our menu widgets built in out of the box. So overall on our Kubuntu, we have very low system RAM. We have the stability of, in this case, being based on the Ubuntu rolling, we have more up-to-date packages, low system memory, and not much more than just a very clean, very vanilla feeling Plasma. Let's have a quick look at the other applications installed. We have mathematics, science, under games. We have some board games, card games, logic games. I really like this controller icon. That's a nice icon there. Graphics, LibreDraw, internet. We have a feed aggregator. We have Firefox. We have KMail. KMail is our only mail applications. I like KMail, but it's very complicated to set up if you have multiple email addresses. It works nicely when you do get it set up, but it's not as simple as setting up, for example, Evolution or, you know, Thunderbird. Basic multimedia. We do have pulse audio volume control out of the box. We have VLC, Cantana. We have K3 for burning. We already looked at our LibreOffice suite. We have Contact for managing personal information. We have K-Organizer. K-Mail is once again there. Basic settings and system utilities. We have archive managers, calendars. That's about it. So even the full install does not give us a lot of bloat. It's just a nice little system. And that's what we get. So let's go ahead and have a look at Feren OS next and see what we find there. And here we are on Feren OS. On Feren OS, we have a lot more customization. So if that's what you want, ultimately that is the distro that you might want to use. We start out with the first time you run it is this welcome screen. So your first option is you can install some firmware. In this case, it detects that you're in a virtual machine. So you want to install those if you want to. If you're not installing on a virtual machine, you will likely not see that one. The next one, actually, you will get a logo or a media codex install. I've already installed the media codex on this. But on Kubuntu, you install the codecs through the Ubiquity installer. On the Calimeris installer, where Feren is installed from, they don't have that option. And so what you're going to do there is you're going to install the media codecs from this welcome screen or not. We've already done that. And then the next, it brings you to this layout here. So you can change from these inside the theme look and feel. Now, this welcome screen is the only place that has this as user-friendly as you will find it. There's tools to do all these things in different places, but this is definitely the best place to do it. You can choose between a tablet mode, the familiar layout, which is like a Windows 10 layout. You can do the Redmond layout, which is more like a Windows Vista or Windows XP. Cupertino is a Mac type layout, and the Ubuntu Unity layout is kind of like Ubuntu Unity. Let's go ahead and just do a couple quick looks at some of these. So looking at the Redmond view, so this is the view that we're looking at here with a basic simple menu like this one here. Your tablet mode defaults, I believe, to an application dashboard. So icons are a little bit bigger. And actually, this one here, I think I told them maybe the dashboard might be better, but we get the standard menu here. Familiar layout, this guy here is going to duplicate your modern Windows 10, including a Windows 10 lookalike tiled manager here as well. Everything on a Windows 10 menu. Cupertino is going to be your Mac type layout. So have our Mac layout down here. And then of course the Ubuntu Unity, if you are used to that. So of course we have this here, and here is our Ubuntu menu. For the purpose of this, let's just kind of stay on the Feren OS default, just because it's going to make it a little bit easier, I think, to find things. Just as far as this menu layout is a little bit different. So the next option we have is our colorization. Now there is a little bit more clunkier tool for the colorization on this, but this one here is definitely the nicest place. So these are your highlights. You'd log out and log back in again to get the full effect, but it should change pretty much wherever you're at. So we have light theme and dark theme and your basic accent color. So if you want to do this, here's more of our dark theme. And then we can choose a variety of different accent colors here as well. Anytime you change a color, it's going to tell you this. And some things like that's not pulling over this menu over here quite yet, but that'll get there eventually. So you can kind of choose the direction that you want to run with that. And then here, if you want to set up your smartphone, if you have an Android, that tells you you can get it on F-Droid or Google Play to configure KDE Connect. This is your night color to reduce eye strain at night. It will basically adjust to the natural light. And now you are all set. The next thing it's going to do is it should pop up a welcome screen here in just a second. But what we'll do is just kind of walk through what we have. I am noticing here on this layout, I don't see a clock down in the bottom because it's up on the top up here with the calendar stuff. That's why you don't see the clock down here in the system tray area. Now, as far as other changes, it does not run every single K application. So, for example, you're not going to get Dolphin on this. You're not going to get Dolphin on this for the file manager. I meant to go with the software stores first. But this case here, instead of using Dolphin, it uses Nemo, which of course comes from Linux Mint. This is an excellent, my favorite file manager here. Let me just go ahead and rehide everything. This is just an excellent file manager. Some people say Dolphin is just absolutely the best. Some people think it's just a little slow and clunky. I think it's a little slow and clunky. It's nice, but it does have some downsides to it. Another issue is the inability to open as root. Dolphin does not allow you to do. Nemo has no problem with. The other area, what I was going to say earlier, is the store. We don't get Discovery, as we mentioned on Kubuntu. Discover is not quite as good as as other file or other software centers. In this case, we have the software center from, again, Linux Mint. And Linux Mint Software Center is absolutely one of the better software centers out there. We have our nice categories. It's quick. It installs quickly. It will tell you if something is from Flatpak or not without you really having to guess. So, for example, GIMP, we have an option that is the Flatpak version and the non-Flatpak version. So if you grab it and you see where it's from, this guy down here, it tells you it's from the PPA. So this tells me that this is the repository version versus this GIMP here is actually coming from a Flatpak. So it's going to tell us that. So you can see down here, remote from FlatHub. So you can get your different versions and understand which one you're getting very quickly. As far as our updates, rather than updating our updates through our discovery, which we said could be a little bit buggy, this one actually gives you, once again, from the Linux Mint team, the Mint Manager, which is just an excellent update manager and where you can adjust things like your Linux kernels and your software updates. You can hold back certain packages, not hold back certain packages. So here's your Linux kernels. Let's go ahead and continue. And then here you can kind of see that you're getting your Linux kernels. We did look at the Linux kernels. We do have a slightly older version one here. We're running the 5.0 kernel versus Kubuntu ran the 5.3 kernel. We're just going to go ahead and close all that out. Let's go ahead and have a look at about our system, just do a comparative of everything else. It looks like we have a slightly newer Plasma, even though the Kubuntu was rolling, and this is based on Ubuntu 18.04. He accomplishes this because Plasma in Feren is actually pulled in from the Neon backports rather than using Kubuntu or an older Ubuntu version of KDE. So here we can see our kernel, like I said, is a little bit older as far as that is concerned. And let's go ahead and have a look at our memory as well. That's something that we did on Kubuntu, which if you remember was running 0.51. This is 0.73, not a significant amount higher, slightly lower, possibly because we've poked around in a few more things here than we've poked around on the other system. But who knows, maybe Feren is actually taking a little bit more system memory. You will notice here that we have Vivaldi installed by default, but the reality is there is a web browser multi-tool that allows you to choose from any of the most popular web browsers you might want to install. The only one installed out of the box is Vivaldi, but you can install Firefox, Chrome, GNOME Web, Chromium, Opera, Brave, or Falcon just with this individual tool here. We also have a few other options, like we don't have Wine in there, which is good. And in our system settings, looking at our themes, we do have the addition here of the different themes here. Now there's a global theme that you'll see on the desktop. That is actually something that is in the menu as well. This global theme kind of gets you back to this guy here. So it says configuration settings already open, the system settings. That's effectively what you get right here. It's the global theme. So this will let you pick from which one of these you want to use. Now, as far as your coloration, there is a colors here, but this is not the same color tool that we saw earlier. For that, you want to look at the colorizer, the theme colorizer. Like I said, this one works. It's just not as nice and nice looking as the one is in the open in the welcome screen, but still Feren cyan dark, Feren green dark, etc. You can pick which one you want. You also though have the ability to create a new theme colorization. So you can do this and you can look at your Feren OS themes. I don't did not check the documentation on how to do that, so we're not going to mess with it. As far as other theming styles, we do have very much like Kubuntu, your basic Breeze, Oxygen, and then we have our Feren versions as well. So we get a couple extra options there. And inside of our Windows decorator, we have Breeze, Feren, Plastique. And so you can see a lot of the theming options and things are the same. There's definitely more options inside of inside of Feren OS here as far as theme colorization than there were in Kubuntu. So that may or may not be something interesting to you. So as far as our applications, we have LibreOffice is installed. We do have Krita, so the addition of a graphics tool. We do have Geary as our email, which between Geary and Kmail, we should install Thunderbird or Evolution instead of either of these. What I don't like about Geary is it's not as much of a mail client as a mail attachment, so it allows you to connect through via IMAP. But the reality is if you're really doing professional email, you need a copy of your emails on your computer for offline work, and Geary just does not allow you to do that. Kmail does, but Kmail is more complicated to set up. I just like using Evolution, which is easy to set up on any Linux distribution. We do only have VLC player here instead of having just a simple lightweight media player. We don't have one of those on here, but we do have VLC. Again, our full Office suite. And under our settings, here's... can't update Chromium. I'm not sure why it can't update Chromium, although that's a bug that I just saw in my Linux Mint today too. So apparently Google's doing something, trying to push out some Chromium issue. Creepy. I don't know what Google's doing, but oh well. Anyway, here's our Office. Here's our settings. We have firewall configurations, disks, software sources, system settings. And then we have a driver manager, something we're also going to see in Kubuntu. As you can see, I'm struggling with the menu here. I do not like this menu. It's not particularly good. It's just too easy to accidentally click something else. So not a lot there. We are going to have a quick look at our Office. I want to see how this version competes with the other version that we looked at in Kubuntu. It does look like it's the same one. They're both running 6.3.3.3. And let's go ahead and do our spieling checker over here. And oh dear, our spieling checker is not installed. Neither is our synonym checker. So there's some key plugins for LibreOffice that are not installed. He did say, though, he is going to be releasing those. Just a note, this is a release candidate. It's not a complete release quite yet. We did look at alternatives. If we look at alternatives in this system here, we have the application dashboard, the application launcher, which is what was used in Kubuntu, the simple menu, application menu, simple menu, and the tiled menu. The tiled menu is Windows 10 start menu. The application menu is the one that is used for the Redmond. So we do have a couple other options there as well. There may actually be some extra widgets as well, but we didn't actually look at our widgets here. We don't actually have the lock widget button up in the corner, which is what we did have up there, but you can actually lock and unlock your widgets and add your widgets here. So clicking this should still pull open our widget panel. We just don't have a simple button for it down up on the icon there. So there is, in a nutshell, Feren OS. As far as considering these two distributions, which one of them is better? Well, they both have a lot of their own specific advantages. Kubuntu definitely has a larger team. They have a more rolling release. And definitely they do have a little bit more of the notoriety being an official Ubuntu flavor. Feren OS Next, however, this does use Neon backports, so you're always going to get a newer version of KDE applications inside of here, and you have a lot more options for theme customization and some other basic system tools to help you with installing web browsers. It also doesn't take just the vanilla approach of doing Plasma, giving you all of the Plasma tools like Discovery and Dolphin. It actually takes each component and says, which one of these would be best? And instead of using Discovery, which is well known to be buggy among, you know, users of the system, it splits us out, uses the Linux Mint software store and Linux Mint updater for that purpose, and it uses Nemo instead of Dolphin, which is kind of a 50-50. I really think that Dolphin is, like, I think Discovery is definitely more objectively not as good. Dolphin, though, is, it's kind of a subjective thing, and whether or not you like Dolphin or not, in favor of Nemo or not, is another option. So both of them are great options. More customization, you want to go with Feren OS. If you don't care about customization, you want a more vanilla experience for Plasma, you definitely want to do Kubuntu. So those are my thoughts. Let me know your comments on these in the description down below.